Hey there, DW here. Welcome to my channel. This is a place where you can relax and listen to stories found on the internet, or not. Before we start anything, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. It would be a great help for my tiny little channel to grow, and plus, it's totally free. Well now, let's start by turning down the background, shall we? Today, we have a nuclear revenge stories posted by Throwaway Mac Throwaway, and their title is Porno Divorce. So this little story begins with me and my wife happily married. We had two wonderful daughters, 13 and 10, and a pretty healthy relationship, or so I thought. Anyways, at some point, things started to appear off. She got very clingy to her phone all of a sudden, made sure to delete the saved password feature on our common PC, started having phone calls that suddenly ended when I came into the house or room. You can probably guess what it was. Now, having 15 years of marriage behind us, I was hoping it wasn't what it obviously seemed to be. So, one day, when she told me she was going to spend some time with the girls, I decided to follow her. Sure enough, I find her driving to a hotel to meet with, let's just call him Mr. P. To say it was a gut punch was an understatement. I literally cried for an hour straight. After I was done with my self-wallowing phase, I decided the best course was getting even. I thought of several scenarios that may or may not have involved me beating Mr. P into a bloody pulp. Eventually, I decided to do things more civilly, and more importantly, legally, but only just. So, the first part of the plan was gathering evidence. I could have just gone a private investigator, but I had something better in mind. So, one day, when my wife was at her job and the kids at school, I installed some small secret cameras and microphones I had bought. Due to the setup for our bedroom, I even managed to get one perfectly overlooking the bed. I didn't, however, use them while I was at home. So a couple days pass when I proposed to my wife that the second to the next weekend, I should take the girls on a trip to land site I will not reveal and stay a night too. At this point, I should also mention that due to her job being pretty demanding and frequently exhausting her, and just due to our various passions and talents, I was always the main caregiver. I more often than not was the one cooking. I took a far more active role in raising the girls and showed them a lot more patience and attention. I didn't spoil them or anything like that, so me going alone with the girls on a trip wasn't that weird. This part will also be very important later. So 2 weeks pass, in which time I get my affairs in order and contact the lawyer to write up a separation agreement that would involve me keeping residence and custody. I go on the trip, try not to give anything away to the girls, and wait to see if Mr. P and my wife fall into the trap. When I returned, I checked the recordings of the weekend. And sure enough, it's a 36 hours F festival. When they weren't effing, the dialogue was something even better. I found out that Mr. P had a wife, though more on her later. But even worse, they also talked about me. And besides the obvious sexual character assassinations that I expected about how small my D was, how I didn't satisfy her, etc., there was some really hurtful stuff. Like her telling Mr. P some of my deepest secrets and shameful stories that I had only told her about, just so they could have a laugh. So, at this point, I didn't have any doubts on what to do. The next day when the kids left, but before my wife left, I confronted her with the video and told her that either she signs the separation agreement and leaves the house, or the girls are going to receive an in-depth explanation of all the orifices mommy got effed in. I wasn't gonna do that, just to be clear. I love my daughters too much. But I put the threat there, and she was too emotional to realize my bluff. She went through all the stages, denying everything, trying to bargain, threatening me, and getting angry. I let it go through all that stuff. Eventually, she signed the paper, and she departed that very evening after she told me her goodbyes to the girls. I didn't show or tell the girls anything graphic. I was always very honest with them, which is another reason why I was always the favorite parent. So I just said that mommy had been very unfaithful. The younger one took some time figuring it out, but that was made up by my older one getting mightily upset. She had just gotten her first boyfriend, as I'm not sure the term really applies at that age, but she knew enough of the world to get pissed off big time. This would be important at a would-be custody battle. As though she did for the moment agree to give over custody, I feared. And I was right to fear that she would try and fight me for the kids. What I didn't expect was for her to use her visitation rights to talk shite about me. Basically, she started telling my younger ones about how it was all my fault for not forgiving her. Her lawyer even started demanding she receive custody. There was no way for her to receive money or the house as she was caught cheating, and in my state, that means quite a lot in divorce proceedings. So I finally activated my nuclear revenge plan. Enter trip to South Carolina. Why South Carolina? Simple. Fort Sumter. I really wanted my daughters to see it. I definitely did not go there because it was one of the last places where revenge porn isn't illegal, and where I could upload my wife and Mr. P's escapades with no worries on Pornhub or other such sites, as you cannot be prosecuted for crimes that weren't illegal when and where they were committed. I sent the links to my wife's employer, her clients, and everybody in her line of work just to be sure, to Mr. P's wife, and to his firm. Mr. P soon got a divorce. I feel sorry for his wife as she was an innocent victim in all of this. But I think it's better that she found out. As for my wife, this was the end of any chance to get custody. She soon got fired from a job of 8 years, and while the revenge porn part was a real dick move that did count in court, it being done in South Carolina, it wasn't illegal or prosecutable. So it could only be used as a minus about my personality. But with my wife unemployed and practically being blacklisted in her profession due to being on Pornhub, as well as the girls, or to put it better, my younger ones being told what to do by my older ones, stating they wanted to stay with me, there was no question on who would get the custody. Yes, due to her being unemployed, I got no alimony. But honestly, I make enough money to sustain both me and the girls, so I don't care, and I'm good enough at caring for them, and they are old enough to allow me to have a full-time job. Several months later, my wife is still unemployed, though I do not know if it's from the porn or from the virus. The girls are growing up just fine, and don't seem to mind not seeing their biatch of a mother. The last time I communicated with my ex-wife was on Facebook, where she told me how I ruined her life and her relation to her daughters, but honestly, I think she earned it. I don't understand why someone who is married would betray their significant other just like that. I mean, sexual insatisfaction was not an excuse. You're a married couple. Tell him. If you thought his PP was too small, ask him to buy a, you know, things that women played with and pleasure you while you both were having fun on your bed. It's kinda your fault too, you know, if you think about it. You chose to accept him in your vows. You can't just say, no, his pee-pee is too small after like having two kids. Just tell him if you're not satisfied. If your partner loves you, they will find more ways to overcome their weakness to pleasure you more. That's what couples do. It is one of your partner's mission to pleasure you, be it women or men. If not, why bother getting a partner in the first place, right? Not just sitting there all quiet and expect your partner to figure out what you want. We are normal human beings. We don't have psychic powers to know what you are thinking. Please communicate. If worse comes to worse, you can ask if he or she would want an open relationship. If they're okay with it, both of you can go out, fool around for a short while, and come back. Don't forget, you have a family. You have responsibilities. Well, I could be wrong. I'm not a relationship expert, you know. That's the story for today. Please give me a thumbs up to show me some support, and subscribe to help my tiny little channel grow. Just click on my icon on the screen or the red button on the bottom right of the video. It's free, don't worry. We'll see you again next time. Have a great night.